Welcome to OSM, peace be with you. I have a real brief health and spiritual update for you as we move into this Memorial Day weekend and as we plan to celebrate the Feast of the Holy Trinity on Sunday. Last Wednesday on the 15th, I was able to have my chemotherapy. My platelets were up and we were fine, and so I went through the process of the 3-day chemo. And this past Thursday, I had a CT scan. And the scan showed that the liver is still clean. The tumor on the pancreas, it was 2.7 in January. Now it's down to 2.0, which is a great decrease. So we're moving in the right direction. This coming Wednesday, if God's willing, I'll be okay to have my next chemotherapy session. And we'll meet with the doctors and see what he thinks of the results of the scan, and maybe how we will proceed in regards to the procedure of chemotherapy in the nearest future. In the last few days, I feel really good. I thank everyone for your prayers. Yesterday was a beautiful day, and I had an opportunity to ride my bike 16 miles just to get out there and blow some stink off of myself and just really have a chance to just zone out in nature and just be with the Lord. So it was a wonderful way to just invigorate myself as we come into this weekend. So I want to thank you for all your prayers, and I'll continue to let you know what is next as things transpire. So remember, it's in times like these that we're forged into saints. So let us all become saints. As I mentioned, the Feast of Holy Trinity is this weekend, and sometimes we don't imagine how incredible it is that God revealed himself in this mysterious way as Father, Son, and Spirit, because when we are trying to follow Christ in carrying our cross, we have to see the relationship of the Father and the relationship with the Spirit, with Jesus as he offers it to us, as a way to follow him. Jesus desires us to follow him by doing what? The will of the Father. That's the love intimacy between the Son and the Father. God so loved the world, he sent his only Son. And his only Son, when he came into the world, redeemed us. Why? Because he was willing to do the Father's work, and that was to offer himself in death. Jesus knows for us to carry our own cross, to say yes to the Father's will, is one that needs the extra power of God's presence with us. And that comes in the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit allows us to integrate our lives with Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit allows us to see the value of fortitude. You know, courage is one thing, but fortitude is more of a perseverance, right? Fortitude of being strong through that cross, getting from the first fall to the second fall to the third fall, without losing our way. To know the wisdom of God means that when Jesus calls us under the way of the cross, he calls us in a way that he wants us to see the path from the Father's view. Suffering is a part of it. Can it be redemptive for us? Can it be efficacious in our own lives? Only if we allow it to enter into that wisdom of God. The knowledge of the Holy Spirit allows us to know that all those who have gone before us who have walked this journey, they too have had an opportunity to fully participate in the love of the Father. And of course, we know the gift of discernment is always the hardest, right counsel. How do we carry the cross? How do we allow what happens to us in the medical sense and treatment versus our trusting in the Lord as he carries us through that? We do all these things, especially through awe and wonder that God created us like him, to be like him. And the only way we're going to become like him if we're purified through our suffering. And to give him reverence always. Because it is in the sacramental life of the church that we gain that strength of the Holy Spirit fully imposed upon us, so that we may carry the cross, to do the will of the Father, and to share in the glory that will come. So I hope this little message reminds you that when you are feeling down or you don't feel as close to Jesus in his suffering, call upon the Holy Spirit, the gifts. Those are gifts. They're to be opened and presented to us so that we may share them in our sorrow, but through the joy that comes in the hope of the resurrection.